So it seems was the case of Noah, the only family that remained uncontaminated from these strange beings that appeared from space. The only line that was pure and clean from God's standpoint to start a new world and a new civilization. Jesus said, as in the days of Noah, so in the days of the coming of the Son of Man. Of all the patriarchs and prophets of the Old Testament, the key to prophecy above all others is Noah. And something happened in the days of Noah that was a distinctive characteristic of Noah's time that didn't happen before or after. Wars and famines and pestilences and natural disasters have always happened. But something happened in the days of Noah, and the most sinister and bizarre of all the things that happened was this intermarriage between the angelic race and the human race. And of course, the mastermind behind it all was another angel, a fallen angel, Lucifer. Now we believe that as they came in those days, we may very well be on the edge of another invasion from outer space, that Satan will once again make another attempt, maybe the final assault on the human race, in order to wean men and women away from the worship of God. He has tried before, he will inevitably try again. And by seducing the human race, by sending these so-called entities from space, demonic beings, he will try to get people all over the world to worship him and to deprive God of the worship that is due to him. Fortunately, we know what the end result is going to be. But this final or omega assault that will come at the end of time may trigger the coming back of Jesus Christ to rescue his own. Satan has failed before, and the Bible predicts he will fail again. We are told quite emphatically in God's word that the kingdoms of this world shall become the kingdom of our God and of his Christ. Satan will make the attempt, but our God, greater is he that is in you than he that is in the world.
Okay, now the other thing you need to know is that essentially there's three kinds of these aliens reported. There's the Greys, which are the little guys that I showed you the picture of. There's the Nordics, and these are the ones that look like us, except better. They're beautiful, blonde-haired, blue-eyed, god or goddess-like figures with incredibly perfect builds, and they look totally human, except maybe they look a little too good to be true. Except for the fact that they are seen in the company of the Greys or other aliens on board UFOs, which makes them seem weird. The third kind, which are the more disturbing kind, are what are called the Reptoids, or the Draconians. These supposedly come from the star constellation Draco, which oddly enough means dragon in Latin. And they look like reptiles. They look like humanoid reptiles. And they apparently are said to have the ability to shape shift, that's hard to say, and appear to be human for brief periods of time, except that their eyes still look reptilian.